so it's like $30 for me.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Yeah.
And then.
Yeah. On my other car, which I don't have any longer, I used to work on it myself a lot. I mean, complex things I would go to that guy I was telling me about. But, you know, smaller things, I would do the same thing. I would go, like, search things on the internet, on YouTube, and just find a do-it-yourself, like, tutorial and do things myself, saving me lots of money.
But transmission is kind of...
Transmission is way beyond my scope. I don't want...
Maybe sell the car. I'm not sure. Something like this, maybe...
Yeah, I'm thinking that I might actually fix it. We'll see what those guys come up with. If they said that... So far, I got one, like, bogus estimate from dealership where they haven't even seen the car. But from the... From the things that the other shop diagnosed, they kind of estimated how much that cost. And they gave me an estimate for about $1,100.
For everything?
Yes, parts and labor. And this shop, if the problem is the same, they say it will go to something like $1,000, right? So, pretty much the same thing, but we'll see. If I can fix it for $1,000, and they can say that, hey, this is a known problem, here's the bad part, we replaced it with this good part, you're good to go, I will probably keep the car. But if they say, well, we fixed it, but, I mean...
You're gonna come up again?
Yeah, if it comes up again, come back, I will probably sell the car.
What year is your car?
It's not new, it's 2008.
2008 is not...
3 years.
Not that old, I mean, for BMW
old.
Is not old.
The problem with that one is it's 5 series and there is lots of electronics in it. So I think they overcomplicated the whole car. It's just... you cannot even... So check this out, you cannot even check the oil level manually.
Why?
It's not possible.
Wow.
Because it's all electronic.
Wow.
You have to... There is a sensor you have to use to see what's the oil level, right? So it's like that with everything.
That's why you always need a mechanic, like, know somebody. Trust it and leave it for him.
No, I mean, this car wasn't exactly the wisest buy. I got it just recently. So my other BMW, which I had before, it was older model. And I got into an accident, I crashed it. So it got totaled. And I decided I want another BMW, but I wanted a nicer one. Got this 5 series. I used to have 3 series.
How long you have this one?
This one? Since September.
Oh, this year?
Yeah. Yeah,
probably the people who sold it to you, they know they have this problem. That's why.
I'm starting to think the same thing.
Because?
I'm starting to think that. Maybe. The price was good though. I mean, I got it from the dealership, so I had to drive to Oregon for this car.
You got it from dealership?
Yeah. Not from the dealership, but like, not from the official BMW dealership.
Because sometimes you get the car from dealership, you can take it back and say your car have
it's
problem.
It's been long.
Yeah.
So I think the... Yeah, they have like, as is warranty. It's been long enough. In any case, we'll see what it is.
Probably these people are good. I don't know. Let's see.
Well, they claim that they have all the necessary equipment, and they say that they are only shop in the area which has like same level of equipment as the official dealership. I don't know if that's that's true.